The Swansea EduNet learning platform is a collection of integrated technologies which support the management and delivery of learning within Gowerton School. For senior managers, it provides instant access to information and attendance, behaviour, and importantly, the progress that individuals or groups of pupils are making in subject areas. The data informs planning and policy within the school, and recently we've invested in iPads for senior staff so that data and documents can be made available electronically in planning meetings. Staff can also access information about attendance, behaviour and pupils' attainment online. Termini reports can be completed via the learning platform, allowing staff to decide when and where they complete this task. Through the Moodle VLE, staff can make available a wide range of electronic resources to support pupils' learning. Use of Moodle has broadened the range of assessment and feedback opportunities available to staff at Gowerton. For pupils, it provides access to relevant and engaging multimedia resources. This is beginning to change the kind of learning opportunities experienced by our pupils. It has increased motivation and allowed pupils to take more responsibility for their own learning, both in and outside school. Via the learning platform, parents are able to access information on attendance, behaviour, and via Moodle, review and support their children's learning. I hope this short video provides an insight into the technologies employed at Gowerton School.
The City and County of Swansea has developed its own learning platform based on SharePoint. It comprises of a public-facing website, a personalised user area where staff and pupils can access email, the user space on the school network and messages. Sims web parts for attendance, assessment, behaviour and report writing are also available through the portal. Gowerton was the first school in Swansea to integrate Google Apps for Education into its platform. We had been using Google Apps since July 2006, and use of Google was fully embedded across the school. We wanted the learning platform to build upon this firm foundation and insisted that Google was fully integrated into our system. Google Apps for Education has a guaranteed 99.9% uptime. It's secure and free. It allows anytime, anywhere access with a built-in potential for collaborative working. Including Google Apps into the learning platform means that pupils and staff have access to the same set of software tools that are not location or hardware dependent. The Moodle VLE is also integrated into the system. All components are available online and with a single login. The Moodle virtual learning environment allows pupils to access a range of interactive learning materials during and outside of lesson times. Homework activities are made available online through the VLE. Pupils complete assessment tasks based on the learning which has taken place in the lesson. The VLE allows staff to track all aspects of the pupil's learning. Pupils are given model answers and feedback immediately. Lessons can be revisited or pupils can be given further information based on their attainment. This is also essential in target setting. Using this data to monitor the quality of learning, teachers track progress and identify areas for further development. This gradebook, which is automatically produced by the VLE based on achievement, also allows teachers to interrogate the data and to analyse performance at whole school, class or at pupil level. Controlled assessment tasks are also uploaded and assessed using the VLE. Mark schemes are shared with pupils as a method of assessment for learning. This allows pupils to make judgments about their own performance prior to teacher feedback. Again, this is another step towards a paperless school.
Hi, I'm Dean Mason. I'm Head of Faculty of Humanities in Gowerton School, and I've always been heavily involved in sport, and since I've been here in school we've always written match reports of sports fixtures that we've had. Rugby is my main interest, but we've written match reports of all things, all sports that we've taken place. Those reports have basically been put on notice boards for pupils to view. In the last 2 years, what's happened is the school has developed a blog, And now, as well as putting the reports up on the notice boards, those reports are now placed on the blog. That gives access to the information to parents, other members of the community, staff, the pupils themselves. We've been really surprised at the number of hits and how popular the blog has been. And one impact that the blog has had is because people are able to view the information more often than just looking on the notice board, it's meant more pupils have wanted to actually be involved in writing the reports. Generally, initially when it was started, it was myself or another member of staff who might write a match report. Now there are people coming along. One lad actually last year went into journalism. He's gone to Worcester to do a course in journalism. And he used to come along and write our match reports. This year, I've had a number of reports which have been written by the students themselves. So that because I put it down to the fact, because they've been able to view things from home and look at them in a little bit more care and detail and just see them viewed on a notice board, it has certainly developed interest. It's made access wider to other people in our community, and it's also helped teaching and learning in that more pupils want to actually be involved in either taking the photographs or actually writing the reports.
We use Google Docs a lot in the science department, and I do a great deal for myself. That one of the great things is, as a father or a parent, I've got my son James at Gowerton, and it's great to see him using Google Docs when he's at home doing work at home. And being a young boy, they're very much more attuned to sort of doing things on a computer, and he'll research and do things and work much more committedly than he would with paper and pen or something like that. Parents' night was a couple of nights ago, and I had some of my year 8 parents in to see me, and they were talking about how delighted they were to have their sons and daughters working together in teams going using the Google Docs. One of the great things about it is that you can have three pupils in their own individual homes working on the computers, working with Google Docs and editing the same document. And if they share it with me and giving me editing rights as well, I can see what they're doing, I can track their work, and I can even edit it and change it online. So when we come into school and they present it to the pupils, they're presenting a high quality finished work. As a teacher, I think it's a tremendous tool. Regardless of the ability range we've got very high quality males and females who use it as a very effective learning tool. They'll go on it, they'll research, they'll find out information. But also with the low ability youngsters, who shy away from committing themselves to pen and paper. They will in fact go on research to find out things. And it's very, very easy to teach them, to guide them not to cut and paste, but to be a bit more discerning of the information they use. So you open up a tool to youngsters that they can actually use the internet to share, they can use it to share with one another, and they can use it in a way that we can have an ongoing evaluation of the work they're doing. It very much aids what we could call teaching and learning. As a teacher, I mean, the library that's available, the resource that's available through Google Docs, I think is tremendous. I mean, it's there. It's not something we have to, in a sense, pay for and buy for each individual pupil. They can all be doing it. I can be working with them from my home when they're doing it as well. And strangely, they don't see it as homework. They just see it as one of the things they do. They work on computers and they use it. So it allows us to extend not only the research ability, but also the communication side, where they can actually sort of develop the ability to use graphics and to see when they're using graphics and images when the science, for example, is getting swamped and dwarfed by all the pretty pictures. And they see it themselves. So it's a very, very good self-awareness tool, self-learning tool for the youngsters. In my lessons, I'm using Google Docs virtually every day and every second lesson almost, depending on what we're doing. At GCSE level, for example, there's a lot more research work taking place with the new controlled assessments going on. They have to research, they have to assess work. And the advantage with Google Docs is they've got a format. We're not in a situation where different youngsters are using different formats to present their work and then it doesn't merge together. But they can be on, they can be researching, finding information, come into school, and they can access the work they've done at home in school and extend their home research work in school as well.